nothing really left anymore. And it was whacked so bad, it started to tear itself apart. If I were to pull it over right then, I wouldn't have to pull it over like that. And it was $300 bump, I didn't want to lose it. So I owned the back of it, and drove all the way to Buffalo. And I was between two storms. And storms go west to east, so I didn't get to see it. And they go all the way, drop that tower on an angle, and you just need to put an angle on it. It's Sunday night, Monday morning, I'm out. I drive it back home, and I never told my wife I bought this car at home.
So I drive the car home, I get four houses away from my driveway, and the sky opens up.
So I just sat under a tree till the rain stopped, and I creeped over, and I looked.
5, 6, 7.
And we hang out in his garage and drink beer, tell bad stories. So I drove clear into the driveway.
Oh, this car is really rare.
And literally every switch,
clear to the crusher.
And I got a camcorder going in the back of the garage. I call up the wife.
Oh, one thing here.
We're out here.
We're up here.
Can you bring me a couple of beers?
Yeah, sure. That's
my motor.
Yeah.
My buddy's work van is in one spot, and this Cherokee red with all the chrome you could get on it, copper, is right next to it. And my wife is like this, the whole life, you know. And so she brings over the beer and says, okay, I'm going home. I said, whoa, wait a minute, did you see this car? And she drops around the van and goes, yeah, what about it? I said, that's our new car. And she turns around and everybody in the garage, Jeff, is that your car? Richie, is that your car? Now she's pissed. She goes home.